What's up guys, I'm Drew Zahoff, and today I'm Maker's Best Friend. I'm going to be testing out 10 TikTok hacks for woodworking, and at the end I'm going to show you some of my own hacks. Check it out. Okay. Yeah, this is always the biggest pain trying to hang these up.
Come check this.
I think I've seen this trick. I think this is going to work out well. I've been meaning to try this. I'm very excited. All right, so you put the painter's tip on, and then you mark where the holes are. You put that where you want to hang it. You screw it in there, and then it should be in the perfect place for hanging up like your battery charger. I've seen them use this for like paintings and stuff. So we're gonna try this, and I think this is gonna work. And this is a huge. This is probably gonna be one of my favorite tips. Let's check it out. So got our charger, painter's tip here. And you want to take a level. We're going to take it and put it up where we want to hang it on our, and we're going to hang it up on our wall hangers for our tools. Make sure you check out that video because these are like the most useful things in my shop. Okay, then you can take off the tape and wow, it's a perfect fit. That's so easy. That's so easy. That's awesome. All right, let's go to the next one.
Hello, friends. I bet you didn't know this about
tape measure hack. You have your tape measure. Oh, yes. You know when you like try to bend the measuring tape up to the point and like it, you never really know because it's curved at the end. You really never know the exact dimension. All right, so you take your tape measure, and for good quality ones, I wouldn't trust the bad quality ones, the back of it actually says the exact width. They actually make these tape measures to be an exact width. If you drop your tape measure a lot, I don't think this works as well if it's a little bit rough on the edges, but yeah. And then he's gonna move it up to the surface, okay? And then you got the exact measurement if you can do math. All right, let's try that out. Okay, this next one is a tape measuring trick that will like blow your minds. And all you really need is to notice on the back of these tape measures that there is a number, there's a dimension on the back of these. And I'd only trust the good ones for this, but check it out. So let's say you have a structure of some sort and you wanna measure the bottom distance, the bottom distance. Imagine these are actually attached to each other. And you're like trying to get a measurement between the two. So you do this like bending trick with the wood, right? And you're like trying to get the measurement. And it looks like it's 11 and a half, but it could be like 11 and 9 sixteenths or something like that. Like a 16th off, which actually makes a huge difference when you're doing wood. So instead of that, if you look at the back, like I mentioned, this says plus 3 inches on the back of this specific tape measure. They're all different, so make sure you check it out. If I put the tape measure inside and push this all the way up against, I'll see this touches exactly at 8.5. You add 3, you got 11.5 inches exact. You know it's not the 1/16th off, and that's how you got your measurement. This will come in handy a lot more if you realize this has a dimension on the tape measure. There you go. Let's move on to the next one. Okay, so you take like an empty water jug or gallon, milk carton maybe, I've got one of those, and they're like drawing out different slots. Did the hammer actually fit in that? I don't know about that. I don't know if I like, it doesn't look as cool. Maybe paint it black or something, and I don't know, doesn't it get flimsy when you start cutting it around? Let's see. Now we got this, the ultimate plastic container. This is a Costco-sized milk jug. Like, this is like the most industrial grade I think you're gonna get for these. If it doesn't work, it would never work. All right, so they drew on theirs, but we're not gonna do that. We're just gonna, this is where this screw will go. I'm guessing they just use like an X-Acto knife to cut it out. Cut out the circle here. All right, that's too big for like that. Maybe this. It like flops all over the place. Like, what is this? It's like not staying still at all. What if I just do like a small slit? I don't know. Just like a tiny slit, all right? How about this screwdriver? Like, why is this useful? why? Why stop at milk jugs, all right? Take this water bottle, all right? Cut a hole. Boom. Screwdriver holder. Genius. Absolutely genius. Complete fail. Come on. This is... Come on. Okay. Oh, I've seen this. I like this. Yeah, because when you're trying to make frames or anything, like, you'll probably, like, nail gun yourself. All right, so you take blue painter's tape. You put the glue. Then the blue painter's tape will kind of keep it aligned when you join it. And then I'm guessing he's going to nail it after. Let's see. He's going to... Yeah, he takes his brad nailer, and then he's going to nail it in, and it's holding it tight, and you can get your hand out of the way so you don't nail it through your hand. That's useful. Let's do that. Let's try this out. This is going to be a good one. Two pieces cut at 45 degrees. So this can make frames, box joints, a whole bunch of good stuff. If you're trying to hold this and attach it, it gets really complicated, gets misaligned, a whole bunch of problems. So let's try this next hack out. Take the tape. Definitely should have done this first, but it's all right. We're going to put it on one half like this. Okay. And then we're going to take the other side. We're going to make the joint, you know, hold it in place like this. Close it on top. Then you put in your wood glue. So it's already there, but let's spread it out evenly. Okay, and then you can close it. And it should make like a perfect miter joint like that. That looks actually really good. Then you can kind of even hold it like this. The tape will hold it together. Then go ahead and take your nailer. And you have like no chance of hitting your fingers, which really hurts. Don't ask me how I know that. And there you go. Perfect 90 degree joint, man. Oh man, it's like so easy. Piece of tape. The cheapest things are your best hacks, guys. All right, let's go to the next one. Ah, okay, a circle jig. What in the world? Why? How is he gonna, how do you measure? How do you measure like this? Like, you put your two screws and then what? You gotta figure out like the extra length of the string to know like the size of your, there's so many easier ways than doing like, that's, all right, we'll do it to prove it, but I'm gonna show you guys like way easier way. Like that's overboard. I realize it's not a circle, it's an oval, I guess, but all you do is you take two screws and you put them in. And then you have a piece of string that measures the size that you want the oval to be, plus the difference that's going to extend from each screw. Again, really complicated to figure this. Like, can I just go around in the circle here? I mean, this is just like, you got nails in your piece of wood or cardboard or whatever now, right? And you're drawing, okay, you got a nice oval. Who measures an oval and needs an oval? I don't know, jeez, fail. For me, this is a fail, this is useless. I'm never gonna use this. So if you watched up to this point, thank you. I hope you guys liked all these hacks. This is my own special hack for creating circles in my mind, the easiest way possible and the cheapest way. And I think you're gonna love this trick. So all you need to do, you take a piece of cardboard. Can be messed up cardboard like this. Doesn't need to be anything serious, but we'll clean it up a little. You're gonna take a screwdriver and you're gonna poke a hole. And then I'm gonna measure the radius, all right? That's half the diameter, right? So half the size you want the circle. So if I want a 5-inch circle, I'm measuring 2.5 inches. I'm making a mark. I poke my second hole. Now, check this out. It's like magic, all right? I'm taking this screwdriver, I'm putting it right at the center of the point I want my circle. I put a pencil into the other hole and I just go around in a circle. And just like that, you have the perfect circle. So easy. I mean, that's a tip I use all the time. Piece of cardboard from Amazon. Hope you enjoy it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure you hit that like and subscribe. Let me know if you guys enjoyed these type of hacks. And if you want more hack videos in the future, think of me even doing like a DIY craft from the dollar store type of hack thing. So comment below any ideas you guys might have, and maybe we'll make that for our next video. As always, thanks again for watching, guys. Peace.